Hey, what's going on to the dog world and my bully family? This is Zeke, Bully Badass TV. I wanted this video to be about breeders and breeding. A lot of times, you know, doing what I do, I get a lot of questions from people who are entertaining the thought of becoming a breeder. And, you know, as someone that's not a breeding Nazi, I'm not, you know, someone that's like, you know, I'm not like heavy into the, like, you know, telling people what not to do. I only suggest, and I'm going to suggest in this video is a suggestion that if you do it, you do it the right way. You take the time and you take the care and the considerations to make sure that your breeding is a well-run business, your dogs are well taken care of, and your customers are satisfied. You know, that's, to me, that's a good business. And quite honestly, in this day and time, you know, breeding is a business. It's more of a business than an art form. I think back in the day, it was more of an art and a science to it. I came across this article. It's a little PDF that was put up by the Canine Association of Western Australia, of all places. But it's free, and it's got a lot of great information in it. So I wanted to share that with you. I'll include the link to the PDF in the description. You guys should go download it. If you're thinking about breeding, definitely go download it. But the PDF starts out with a question, and the question is very simple. Why breed? That's a great question. I think if anybody wants to get into breeding, that should be a question that you should have a great answer to. Why are you breeding? Breeding dogs is a venture which should not be embarked upon without full and proper consideration to the many important facets and requirements involved. High on the list of essentials is time. Puppies will need feeding 4 or 5 times a day, and we'll need someone on hand to monitor the ambient temperature, whether it's too hot or cold, and to adjust the temperature for the puppies accordingly. If there's nobody available to attend to the puppies during the day, please forget about breeding. The article continues. The common concept that purebred puppies are a means of making money is, in a reality, a misconception, and alone not a valid reason to bring otherwise unwanted dogs into the world. Our first and foremost consideration should be to breed to improve the quality of the breed. That's a very good point. As members of our state body, we should all be well aware of the code of ethics which all members are required to follow. Generally, members venture into breeding only after having tasted moderate success with a purebred puppy in the show ring. As a dog matures, they are drawn towards continuing their success with the progeny of their young winner. This is acceptable as they would probably have obtained their first show dog from a reputable breeder who is able to guide them through their first breeding experience, just as they probably guided them through their first show experiences. Generally, a poor specimen who had failed to earn any consistent success will also tempt its owner into the breeding experience in the hope that something better could be produced if a winning mate were chosen. Unfortunately, this decision will generally lead its breeders down the path of failure. Although the first ethic is being followed, its chance of success is minimal when compared to that of the winning competitor, who is already a jump ahead in the race for perfection and competition. When it comes to the question of breeding to improve, if exhibition of the resilient stock is a reason for breeding, then breeding from a poor or mediocre stock is a mistake. If the show ring is not the ultimate aim of the product you're breeding, there should be a very clear goal set for achievement. If you are breeding for superior retrieving ability, then it should be patently obvious that the parents of the litter would be chosen with that in mind. The police now have in place their own breeding program based upon the traits required in the dogs they work, rather than relying on hit and miss opportunities previously afforded them by taking in other people's cast off dogs for training. Similarly, the guide dogs for the blind and other organizations are now breeding with a definite goal in mind for achievement. Without very clear ideas and goals set for what you wish to achieve in breeding a litter of ANKC registered puppies, there can be no truly valid reason for doing so. If within the breeding stock you have under your control, the ability to produce your aim does not genetically exist. Do you wish only to produce a litter of pedigree puppies for sale as pets? If so, there are still very clear guidelines and demands in the end product. Perhaps every bit as stringent as required as a show dog. It is therefore your responsibility to provide the market a dog which is typical of its breed and appearance, which has a reliable and tractable temperament for simple training, which will not be requiring veterinary attention as a result of unsoundness or heritable problems like hip dysplasia, cataracts, or any of a number of abnormalities which may make ownership of such a dog a hardship. Quite simply, the reasons for breeding a litter must be clearly perceived and set down as goals for achievement prior to breeding any litter of puppies. And there should be a good chance of achieving these goals from the stock we use. Based on known factors, it is our responsibility to ascertain that these factors are indeed present before embarking on a breeding venture. Therefore, we must make an effort to educate ourselves in order to set our aims and achieve them. So there you go. That's the first page. Hopefully, you know, again, my reading wasn't too bad. I'll edit it. I'll chop it up to make it kind of sound better. But I think if you read that first page, you get a clear understanding that, you know, the purpose of any breeder, according to the code of ethics, is to breed to make the breed better. If you're going to breed dogs, you should breed winning dogs. You don't plan on taking mediocre dogs and thinking you're going to get something better than mediocre. And then lastly, even if you're breeding for pets, those pets should be sound and should have a tractable temperament. I've never really heard that phrase before, but a tractable temperament. And they should not provide the owner of the pet any hardship. So that's what's up with that. Check out the PDF. The website, the web address is in the description. Go check it out. Read the whole book if you're thinking about breeding. If you just like to read something, go read it. If you just want the information, go read it. Again, this is your boy Zeke, Bully Badass TV. Thanks so much for checking out the channel. I appreciate the support. Like, love, subscribe, share. I'll talk to you guys later. Peace.